Welcome to Chess Killer Tips, the chess podcast, which is fun to watch and which helps you improve your chess.
Hi, welcome to Chess Killer Tips, brought to you by Chess King Chess Software. I'm Steve Lopez. We have a position here from a open tournament in Augsburg, 1995. A couple of masters are playing, and white has just played rook b6. We'll show you that move. I suppose to protect the bishop on b2. So it's now black's move, and your task is to find the best move for black in this position. Pause the video if you wish, take as much time as you need, and I'll be back after the music with the solution. The winning move in this position for black is pretty subtle. Every time that I look at this game, I think of the old Aaron Nimzowitsch line about threats and executions. The big winning move here establishes a threat. Here's what happens. There's a box around this pawn for a couple of reasons. One is that is the move, c4, but the other thing is that c5 is important. The reason why that pawn moves is because black wants to get his bishop onto c5. If the bishop comes to c5 in this position, if it was black's turn to move, there would be two threats. One would be bishop takes b6. The other would be rook f2 mate. If the black bishop was here, it would be attacking this rook, and this rook could come here and checkmate. So that's what black wants in this position, is to get the bishop to c5. White has some things he can do here. None of them are especially great. One of them is to play bishop a1, after which here's the threat. And this would be the only way that white could respond to that threat. This move takes care of both problems. But instead of taking on b2, black surprises with a check. King comes to e2. And now black has won a pawn. So instead of bishop a1, white plays rook b7, attacking this bishop while covering his own bishop on b2. Here comes the big threat move, of course. The threat is rook f2 checkmate. Of course, this rook is no longer endangered. White decides to attack the bishop. He could also have tried something like, rook d7 check, which superficially looks good until you see the reply of king c6, which now means that the king attacks the rook, and this rook attacks this bishop. So that's no good. So after bishop c5, white plays this to attack the bishop, but it doesn't matter because the next move is checkmate. So there are threats and executions, but you have to set those threats up, and sometimes very subtle moves like this pawn move sets up the threat, which then wins the game. It's as simple as that. Come back again soon for another Chess Killer Tip, brought to you by Chess King Chess Software.
Hello everybody, I'm Alexandra Kustinyuk, the 12th Women's World Chess Champion. In my videos, I'm using the coolest chess software on the chess market, which is the Chess King software, with the strongest chess engine, Houdini 2, and the biggest Giga King database. And if you want to become a cooler, stronger, and more advanced chess player, I would definitely recommend you get this chess software, especially using this promotional code that you see on your screens. I hope my videos and the Chess King software will help you to fulfill your chess dreams.
Thanks for watching the Chess Killer Tips podcast.